Despite being my best friend, honey, you don't get to call me. You have a horrible habit of calling me at all odd hours of the night, and I don't like that.
Okay, then
My profile
I'm going
picture
to switch that
also.
permission off for you too. Bye bye. You can't call me either. Hey guys, welcome to the first product walkthrough video of Port. We basically take you through what Port is and how to add contacts on Port. The biggest differentiator about Port is the fact that we use no contact info to connect people. The reason we do this is to give you as much control as possible. On Port, you'd never get spam because there is no contact info to spam. On Port, you get to control who gets to talk to you and how much access they get to you. If somebody starts bothering you too much on Port, you can disconnect and walk away. Let's actually get into how connecting works on Port. First off is onboarding. Onboarding is the quickest process ever in a communication app. All you have to do is enter a name, click continue, and you're done. That's it. This is all of onboarding. Because Port lets you control how much access people get to you, you get to control all sorts of permissions to yourself. You get to decide if people can notify you, call you, connect you with other people, and even see your display picture. Anyway, since this is a demo video, I'm going to give people access to all permissions. Let's proceed.
So good idea to note that the name that Ani just entered was a nickname. Multiple people can have the same nickname, and if he chose to upload a profile picture, that would also be something that we at Port never see. All your information is end-to-end encrypted between you and the person you wanted to connect with.
Let's just change our profile picture. Let me just choose pencil head. Okay. Now, because Port uses no contact info, the way you connect with people is by creating a new port. You can think of a port as a QR code or a link you use to add new contacts. By these links and QR codes are single use, which means only one person can connect with you using them. But you can decide to create multi-use QR codes and links which multiple people can use to scan and connect with you. Let's create a one-time use port and let's use this to invite Abhi, my co-founder and best friend. Cool. What kind of permissions do we want to give Abhi? Well, let's give him everything. Since Abhi is a good friend of mine, I don't mind him notifying me whenever or calling me or even sharing my contact. So let's create a port for Abhi. Abhi, would you mind scanning my port to connect with me?
Of course. So first thing that happens when I scan this port is I get to choose permissions exactly the same way that Ani just said his. My profile picture isn't exactly appropriate for a product demo, so I'm going to turn that off. But we work together. Ani needs to connect me with other potential users, so I'm going to leave contact sharing on. Let me go ahead and save the contact, and the connection should pop up.
Neat. Now we're connected with Abhi. Let's send him a message.
It's a good idea to note that the port that we just used to get connected is now completely useless. There was never any information in that identify Ami except his nickname. And of course, that isn't unique either. Now that we've connected, if you try to reuse the port, go ahead. If you are watching this at home, you will not connect to him.
No, you will not. It'll throw an error. So that's right, Abhi. The biggest benefit is unlike contact info, which can be used to aggregate data around you and can be misused by other people to basically find out more about you or randomly connect with you, spam you, and send you unsolicited messages, ports don't have any of those issues. Anyway, I think if Abhi's not going to give me profile picture permissions, which he clearly hasn't, I'm not going to let him see my profile picture either. So let's go. Now,
that's all right. Where do you go?
Yep. And you can do everything you can do on Port on any other messaging app. You can send your images, you can send files, and you can even experience crystal clear audio and video calling. Let's go ahead and call Abhi.
Let's do it the other way. Let me call you.
Okay. Yeah, and just like you can enjoy all the features you would on any other communication app. Hey Abhi, how's it going?
It's going all right. Don't mind the mess in my room. I'm rotting this week.
Okay, anyway, I'm going to cut the call now. Bye bye.
See you.
Now, let's say Abhi was a spammer. Let's say I connected with Abhi, but then I started regretting it because he started sending me so many messages that it just became overwhelming. I can just disconnect with Abhi and completely walk away. And he'll never be able to bother me again because there's no contact info to bother me with. So Abhi is donezo. He'll never be able to send me messages again. If Abhi wants to connect with me again, I have to consent to it with another port, which I'm never going to do. Let's consider the case of reusable ports. Now, if you're connecting with some close friends, sure, ports are great. But if you want to make yourself discoverable online, if you want people on, let's say, LinkedIn who come across your profile to connect with you and maybe start a chat with you, then maybe a one-time use port isn't the best idea. Maybe you would want a reusable port for that. I have conveniently set up a reusable port called LinkedIn. Let me not create one here, but I've already created one on my personal device. And for those watching, I have put it up on my LinkedIn site. So if you go to my personal LinkedIn site, you will notice a reusable port that connects with me. Let's try to connect with my actual device using this demo device. Let's click on this. Fantastic. Now, I'm adding a new contact. Just like with any connection, I get to decide what kind of permissions I want to give away. Since I'm basically connecting with myself, I'll give all permissions. Now, fantastic. I'm connected with myself. And my personal device, you will notice a new connection. That's reusable ports. There's so much else you can do on port. You can also create groups where you basically can form a tight-knit community with people without worrying about your personal information being misused by people around you. Now that me and Abhi are connected, let's say Abhi starts abusing the access I've given him. Shit, he's already doing it. What the hell are you sending me, Abhi? Okay.
I'm trying to show them that we have images. We also have videos. Let's see if I can find a good one.
You're also showing them your sense of humor. And how terrible it is.
Impeccable, isn't it?
Okay, anyway, I'm done with you. I'm disconnecting with you. You'll never be able to bother me again. Bye-bye. You're gone from my life. Well, I've changed my mind. And if you do change your mind, and if you want to connect with contacts you've disconnected with, you just have to create a new port. That's it. Let me create a new port. Abhi, do you want to scan my port again?
Just this once.
Okay, perfect. And if Abhi scans my port again, our conversation resumes from where it stopped. And we're back.
I'm free to send him all the voice notes.
Sorry, I disconnected.
Images, videos, terrible memes, and terrible hot takes all the time.
And I can always delete those too. Well, maybe I'll forward it to some of my friends. You can do everything else you do in any sort of messaging app, obviously. We showed you calling, you can record voice notes. Yeah. You can send large files, videos, images, and as always, you can send contacts. One of the best things about port is I can share Abhi's contact if he's given me permissions to do so. Let's try and share Abhi's contact. Oops, Abhi has not given me permissions to share his contact. That's a little surprising. Abhi, please, for the love of God.
I will do it only if you promise to not connect me with your little cousin who wants to borrow my Minecraft account again.
Deal. I'll share it with my other device.
Got it. You can now connect me with whoever you deem fit.
Perfect. Now let's share Abhi's contact. I'm going to connect Abhi with myself. Hey. Abhi wants to connect with you. Perfect. Done. Now, when I click on this from my other phone, I connect with Abhi. And Abhi gets to know how that connection came to be. So if I share Abhi's contact with somebody and they connect with Abhi, Abhi knows that that connection happened because I shared his contact. So with every connection on port, you know exactly how it formed. You can do other stuff on port too. You can create numberless groups where you can create groups where you don't have to expose your personal contact information. Port also lets you keep track of all the ports you've created. So if I were to create a port that nobody immediately scans or clicks on, I'm aware of it. So let's say I create a port for Janice and she doesn't use this immediately. I can always check that out in my ports tab. Hey, here's a port for Janice that she hasn't used that she has 6 days to use. If she doesn't use it in the time, port automatically gets destroyed. All of my port contacts are available here. So if ever I want to chat with them, disconnect with them, or share their contact, they're available right here. Right, you can always edit your default permissions whenever. So your net new ports have different permissions. You can also change your port permissions at the time of creating the port as well, or at any point later. Every chat is under your control as well. So you can always change your permissions for a chat at any time. If for some reason port's not the right fit for you, you can just delete your port account and walk away. As always, we don't collect any of your personal identifying data. If there's any interesting use case of port that you've personally found out, we'd love to hear about them. You can connect with anybody on our team. Check us out on our LinkedIn or our personal websites. We have a website for the company, numberless.tech. Check it out. You have a way to connect with every member of the team through our numberless.tech website. Cheers. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.